thanks to heroic cop terrorist is forced to answer questions about his actions. Sniped Officer Ryan Nash, the cop whose quick-thinking actions prevented suspected Islamic terrorist Saif Losipov from harming more New Yorkers during an attack Monday, did more than merely stop the jihadi's rampage, he also made it possible for Saipov to later be questioned. According to the New York Post, Nash had been out on a routine call to locate what the paper described as an emotionally disturbed person when he came face to face with Saipov, Uzbek national who had rammed a Home Depot rental pickup truck into pedestrians. Following the attack, which ended when Saipov reportedly crashed the truck into a school bus, the Islamic terrorist exited his vehicle armed with a paintball gun and pellet gun and tried to flee from the scene. That's when Nash made his move. Nash gave chase, drew his weapon and opened fire, bringing down the 29-year-old suspect before he could do any more harm, the Post reported. Here's the key, as noted by local station WCBS, Nash fired only one shot. This is important because had he fired any more shots, Saipov may have died. But because he survived, he's currently undergoing questioning, the station pointed out. Though nothing can be done to bring back the 8 innocent Americans who were killed because of Saipov's sick actions, this questioning could conceivably provide authorities with a much-needed glimpse into what and or who radicalized him. All that was known as of Tuesday morning was that Saipov was a lone wolf who became radicalized domestically while living in the United States, and that he had been influenced by the Islamic State and its violent tactics after arriving in this country from Uzbekistan, as reported by the Washington Post. But many other questions remain to be answered. Had he been in touch with any Islamic State group militants? If so, who are they? Where do they live? Are they trying to radicalize others in the U.S. and elsewhere? Questions have also emerged about the Masjid Omar Mosque in Paterson, New Jersey, which NorthJersey.com reported Saipov attended. This mosque has reportedly been under surveillance by NIPT authorities since at least 2005 as part of a program to identify budding terrorist conspiracies. Authorities now need to determine when Saipov began visiting the mosque, why he visited it, whether he knew anyone there personally, etc. This brings us back to Officer Nash, whose incredible actions Monday not only saved lives but paved the way for these questions to be answered sooner rather than later. In most terrorist attacks, the suspect winds up dead either because of a self-inflicted wound or because of wounds incurred during shootouts with the authorities. In this amazing case, we have a chance to get some real answers, and for that we owe Officer Nash a lot.